Yes, guys, we are continuing with question number 17, but if I do this in a shortcut method, with that shortcut method can be that if I consider x square equal to y, and then divide into partial fractions, and finally we'll substitute the value of y as x square, and then we'll solve it. So it can take less time. Okay, so let me, instead of doing this, because it's a lengthy method, may have number of mistakes inside if we are not paying attention towards it. Okay, without attention, if we are doing this, it may take a lot of time and efforts as well. So for that, let me solve it by another method, which is simpler method. So let me take it in a simpler way. Okay, so that will be better. So that one can do in another way. I have just illustrated this method, that how we have to solve it by this lengthy method. Now let me take the shortcut method. What is shortcut method? Okay, if I consider that y, x square equal to y, okay, so then we divide into partial fractions, this fraction, and then finally we substitute the initial value and then resolve it. Let x square equal to y. Therefore, 1 upon this is y minus 1 whole square into y square plus 1 whole square is equal to let. Okay, so this can be written as 1 upon this whole equal to, okay, where x square equal to y. Let x square equal to y. Then this is equal to, then let 1 upon this is equal to a upon, now this is y minus 1 whole square, that means y minus 1 v upon y minus 1 whole square plus c upon y plus 1 plus d upon y plus 1 whole square. Or if I cross multiply, or if I multiply this equation, this whole equation, y minus 1 whole square plus into, sorry, this is y plus 1 whole square, not y square, I'm sorry. So if I multiply this, the both sides of this equation by y minus 1 whole square and y plus 1 whole square, then we will get 1 is equal to a into, see, y minus 1 into y plus 1 whole square, b into y plus 1 whole square plus c into y plus 1 into y minus 1 whole square plus d into y minus 1 whole square. Now let me further resolve it. It is y minus 1 into y square plus twice y plus 1 plus b into y square plus twice y plus 1, okay, plus c into y plus 1 into y square minus twice y plus 1, sorry, plus 1, okay, and plus d into y square minus twice y plus 1. Okay, now let me further solve these two steps, a and c. This will be a into, let me multiply by y first, y cube plus 2 y square plus y, then minus y square minus 2 y minus 1. Okay, and plus this b as it is, b square, sorry, y square plus twice y plus 1 plus c into, this is y cube minus 2 y square plus y plus y square by 1 minus twice y, this is minus twice y plus 1 is added. Okay, so let me write it up. This is plus twice y, so I multiply by 1 into, sorry, this is minus twice y. So initially first y into plus y, which is, this is minus twice y square, alright. So I multiply by 1. Plus y square minus twice y. D into the same as y square minus twice y. Thank you. one equation, one of d will be calculated, others will be 0. One is twice of 2, y into 1 in this equation will be 2 and minus 2 that will be 0. And d will also be 0, so minus twice by the equation. B will be only calculated. B is equal to b 1, 2, 4, b. Remember that b is equal to 1. Y plus 1 whole square equal to 0, or y plus 1 equal to 0, or y is equal to minus 1 in plus 1. In first period, okay, y minus 1 in first position. D can be calculated, so it's 0. Minus 1 into minus 2 means plus 2. This is already plus 1. Plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 is 4. This is 4. D is equal to 1 or D is equal to 1.4. Okay, so D is also 1.4. Now let me equate the coefficients to frame the equations. For making the equations, to find the value of the constants, let me compare the coefficients. On comparison of coefficients, coefficient of y cube, this is y cube, coefficient of y cube, y square, y and constant, we get here y cube coefficient first 0 equal to a only plus c, right? Y cube is only a and c, so a and c are 0. Then y square coefficient is 0 equal to plus a, y square plus b, minus c and plus d, y square. Alright, this is second, let me take second equation. This is the third one. Right. Now coefficient of y. Now here it is 0 equal to minus a, y plus 2y, sorry, 2b plus 2b, y coefficient, this is minus c, this is minus 2d. This is fourth equation. Now for next one, constant coefficient, 1 is equal to, this is minus a plus b, okay, plus c and plus d. This is your fifth equation. Now solving this and substituting value of b and d, which we have already calculated, we can get second for the third equation, and then first the second and third we can solve. So substituting value of b and d in second equation, so in third equation we get it is 0 equal to a plus 1.4 value of b, okay, and plus, sorry, minus c plus 1.4b value of d here. So 1.4. Okay, so this simply gave us, this implies that 1.4 plus 1.4 is 2.4, that means 1.2. So a minus c is equal to minus 1.2. Okay, and from third one we have a plus c is equal to 0. So solving it, adding and addition. On addition, this is equation number second. This is the same third one which we have simplified. So adding these on addition we get. So on addition we get here twice a cc cancelled out is equal to minus 1.2. So a is equal to minus 1.4. Taking 2 to that side, this is minus 1.4, a is equal to. Now the other value is c. Why? Because a plus c equal to 0. When a is equal to minus half, sorry, minus 1.4, so c will be positive 1.4. Okay, so 4 constants are now terminated. Now let's finally resolve this equation. So this will give us the partial fractions of this fraction in terms of y, which we have calculated the values of. This constant is 22nd. Okay, so finally we have got a is 1.4 minus 1.4, that means minus 1.4 into y minus 1. Y is here the true value of y, that means x is here minus 1. Okay, and plus b is 1.4. 1.4 into x square minus 1 whole square. C is also positive, this is 1.4 into x square plus 1. Okay, and plus d, d is also 1.4 into x square plus 1 whole square. This is the value of all these. Now let me integrate them. Therefore, integration dx upon this value, this one let me take. X square minus 1 whole square into x square plus 1 whole square into 3 whole square. Yes, they are already there. They give us what we will take this as minus 1.4 common sign of integration. This is dx upon x square minus 1 plus 1.4 sign of integration dx upon x square minus 1 whole square plus 1.4 sign of integration. Dx of that. This is x square plus 1 plus 1.4 sine of integration 1 point x square plus 1 whole square into dx. Okay, now therefore integration of this will be, this is x square minus a square type. This is 1.2a minus 1.4 into 1.2 log of direct integration. This is x minus 1 upon x plus 1 in the denominator. Okay, so this is the integration of x square minus a square type. This here we know from the formula of integration. Now plus 1.4. Now if I substitute here, this is, let me take I1, I'll solve it separately. Plus this is 1.4 tan inverse x only. Plus this is 1.4, let me take this as I2. Let me solve I1 and I2. And then finally you will solve or substitute the whole value. So this I1, which is I1 is equal to sine of integration dx upon x square minus 1 whole square. Now putting here or substituting x equal to second theta. Let me take. Therefore differentiation with respect to theta we get here is dx upon d theta is equal to second theta into tan theta. Differentiation. Okay, second theta, tan theta. Right. And tan theta differentiation is second square theta, but second theta, tan theta differentiation. So this implies that dx is equal to second theta into tan theta into d theta. Okay, so substituting these values here in this equation, we will get second theta tan theta d theta divided by second square theta minus 1, that means tan square theta inside, so it will be tan 4 theta, tan 4 theta whole square. Okay, so that means 1 tan theta gets out, it is nothing but sec theta d theta upon tan cube theta. 10 cubed theta, right? Or if I just resolve it as sin theta upon cos theta, sin theta upon, sorry, this is 1 upon cos theta in the numerator. In the denominator, we have sin q theta upon cos q theta. So that will be cosec q theta into, now 1 cos square theta will also come out into v theta. Alright, so if I substitute cos square theta as 1 minus sin square theta, then that can give us 2 forms. So let me substitute that value. This is nothing but cosec q theta. Why? Because sin q theta upon cos q theta in the denominator, cos q theta will come in the numerator, and 1 upon cos theta will be second theta. The cancel out cos square cos q theta is 1 cos. This is the value. So finally, let me solve it here. And okay, all these things are solved. Let me take here. Okay, so this is can be eliminated. This can be eliminated. Now let me take this also. Finally, the integration. Let me write this. This is here. This answer will be sign of integration minus 1.8. Sorry, this is integration. Is nothing but minus 1.8 log of x minus 1 upon x. The first step. Okay. This one, let me write here, plus 1.4 tan inverse x plus 1.4. This is I1 plus I2. Let me take I1 plus I2. And I1 we are doing here. And here I1 is, we are solving this as cosec q theta into cos square theta is 1 minus sin square theta. Okay, so this is there, that I have already written there, and this I2 is 1.2. This where I2 is equal to sin of integration 1 upon x square plus 1 whole square into dx. This is I2. And now let me write the code. Then you have to solve this equation. So finally, we have obtained that simplified form. Now let me integrate these two functions and substitute them here in this equation. So let me take this equation and integrate the equation. Let me take any equation number. It may be taken as first, like this. Integration complete. Okay, now let me take this. This is nothing but cosec q theta. Okay, into d theta minus sine. This is what? Now, one cosec theta will be there. Only one cosec theta will remain because sine square theta. And this is cosec q theta. Means 1 point sine q theta. Only 1 point sine theta. That's what that means. Now, this let me integrate. Now if I integrate this as taking cosec theta into cosec square theta cosec square into d theta by parse method and keeping this function as it is. So using by parse, this is for differentiation, this is for integration. Because cosec theta can be integrated. This is second function, this is first function. Using by parse. Using by parse method, integration of this whole, integration first part, integration of first parts of it, first part of it will be, okay, so this will be, now first function as it is, that means cosec q theta, cosec theta, so as it is, integration of cosec square theta. Okay, minus sine sine of integration. Differentiation of cosec theta is minus cosec theta cot theta. That means it will be cosec theta into cot theta. Why minus 1 plus? Because differentiation of cosec theta is minus cosec theta into cot theta. Okay, now cosec integration of cosec square theta, that is minus cot theta, again it will be negative sign. minus cot theta. Okay, into d theta. Now if I just replace cot square theta, this is cot square theta, and this minus half of integral of cosec theta, I'm not going to integrate, but this will be eliminated. This will give us cosec theta minus sine, this is cot theta integration, minus cot theta of this. This is a minus sine, let me replace this. Now this is cosec theta, cot square theta is cosec square theta minus 1 into d theta minus sine of integration cosec into d theta. Now this value, let me write here, this value is nothing but cosec cube theta minus sine cosec cube theta d theta, which is the same value, plus sine, it is cosec theta into 1, that means plus value cosec theta into d theta. This minus cosec theta into d theta cancel out these two. Only this one is I, which we took here, this I1, sorry. This is I1 here, minus I1 can be taken this side, it is twice I1 equal to only this side. This is minus cosec theta into cosec theta. This first step is like, because it's negative. If you take it to left hand side is having cosec cube theta, which is this. Cosec cube theta we have. Look at this. Okay, not. But this one, we have taken this value. Cosec cube theta we are integrating. We are integrating this value only. So this is the same thing. Cosec this, I am not integrating. If I integrate this value, and this is this gap as it is, it can be taken as this whole. This is minus cosec cube theta, the same value I, minus I can be taken this side by integrating this. Okay, then that this plus cosec theta, if I add this value with this, first let me calculate this value, will give us I1 is equal to minus 1.2, therefore I1 equal to minus 1.2 cosec theta into cot theta. I1 is minus cosec theta into cot theta. We have just integrated this one. This integration is minus this. Now if I take this to this side, twice of this, because then this value will be equal to half of this. Okay. So nothing else we have done. Only this we are integrating, this we are keeping additive. Okay, so these two are cancelled out finally. Okay, so this I1. Now I1 can be then finally substituted cosec theta, cos theta will be this. Now finally, we have considered as, okay, x as whether x equal to second theta. We consider x equal to second theta in this situation. Okay, now first, in the second one, I2. What is the I2 here? Let me take now I2. I2 is giving us y square into this. Okay, that let me solve. So I2 here is sine of integration of 1 upon x square plus 1 for the square root of dx. Now let's substitute here x equal to 10 theta. Therefore dx equal to second to square theta into d theta. Substituting this whole value here, this is 1 upon for the second square theta into d theta divided by, this is 1 plus 10 square theta, 1 plus 10 square theta whole square. This is giving us second square theta d theta. Well, this is second square theta inside the bracket. Second square theta whole square, that means second whole theta, whole power. One square theta cancelled out. It is nothing but 1 upon second square theta. D theta, that will give us cos square theta. D theta plus cos square theta. We know that this is 1 plus cos 2 theta. Okay. So this will give into d theta. This will give us 1.2 into theta d theta plus 1.2. Tan of integration, this is 4 theta d theta. Now integration of this will be theta only. But this is 1.2 sine 2 theta upon 2. That means this is 1.2 theta. Here is this one, tan inverse x plus 1.2 here, this is 2 sine theta cos theta divided by 2 to cancel out. As sine 2 theta equal to, you know, sine 2 theta equal to 2 sine theta into cos theta. This is this formula we have, and this cos square theta we have substituted here. Since and cos square theta is equal to 2 cos square theta equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta, this we know. Since measure of this, since this is equal to this and this is equal to this, and sine 2 theta equal to this, we have used these two formulas here, trigonometric identity formula. Now, since tan theta equal to x, therefore from this right angle triangle, this is theta, this right angle, hypotenuse, hypotenuse is 1 plus x square, this is x, this is 1 here, sine theta from this equation is x upon under root 1 plus x square, and cos theta will be 1 upon under root 1 plus x square. Now if I substitute these two values, sine theta, cos theta here, in this case we will get 1.2 tan inverse x as it is, plus 1.2 sine theta is x upon this and cos theta is 1 into this, so it will be x upon 1 plus x square only, or x square plus 1. But after multiplication, this square root will be cancelled out. Only 1 plus cos x square will be there. 1 plus x square. This is the value of I2 here. Now let me substitute these values. Now in this case, cos x theta is what? We have, if I substitute this as minus 1.2, cosec theta, I1 minus, now converting that into x, it will be minus 1.2. The cosec theta is 1.sine theta. And this is cos theta upon sine theta. Okay, so it will be sine square theta and cos theta. Or let me take the same value, because we have to find out second theta. We substituted for the second theta, we substitute x equal to sec theta. I'm sorry, this is x equal to sec theta we consider. If I just find out value of cosec theta, cos theta, then substitute here, that will give us the same value. So let me write the same here. This is cosec theta into cos theta. Now since this was there, sec theta equal to this value, let me write here. So that will give us, okay, this is right angle triangle theta, here it is right angle, and this is hypotenuse. Sec theta is equal to hypotenuse upon, so this is hypotenuse upon base, this is 1. It will be x square minus 1, this will be, okay, so the hypotenuse square minus base square equal to this value. So this one x upon hypotenuse upon base sec theta. Okay, so now let me find out other values. What is cosec theta here? Therefore, minus 1.2 cosec theta will be hypotenuse upon this. This is x upon under root x square minus 1 into cos theta. Now cos theta is this upon this, means base upon perpendicular, that means 1 upon under root x square minus 1. Okay, so this value will be, yeah, x square minus 1. So this will be the same value. In this case, it's x square, only x square minus 1 will come out, x upon under root x square minus 1. So this is the final value of this. Let me write here, this is minus x upon x square minus 1 into 2. This is minus x upon 2 into x square minus 1. This is the value of I1. So I1 plus I2. If twice of 2 is that there. I2 is this. Then the answer will be, so let me finally write the answer. What is the answer? Final answer will be only I1 plus I2. I1 is this and I2 is this. This is I2. This is I1. Subsuming these two values of I1 and I2 here. Final answer will be minus 1.8 into log of S minus 1 upon S plus 1 value plus 1.4 and inverse S this value plus 1.4 I1 is this. This is minus S upon 2 into S squared minus 1. Okay, and plus 1.2 tan inverse. Plus 1.2 x upon 1 plus x square or x square plus 1 only plus constant of integration that will take k. This is the answer, but there are two similar terms. This one 1.4 tan inverse x, this is 1.8 tan inverse x. So that will be that minus 1.8 log of x minus 1 upon x plus 1 plus this value 1.8 because 1.4 is 1.8 10 plus 6 1.8 plus 1.4 8 LCM 2 plus 1 3 upon 8 3 upon 8 10 inverse 6. I have combined this one and this one 1.8 1.4 8 LCM 2 plus 1 is 3 upon 8 8 LCM. Okay, so now these two steps are left over. That will be, let me separate them. 1.8